Hi everyone, I hope you are all doing good. Today we are going to see the static rotor resistance control of induction motor through this video lecture. In the last video I have posted, we discussed about rotor resistance control of induction motor, that is by means of adding external resistance into the rotor side of the induction motor and varying it by any mechanical means. Today in this lecture we are going to see the static rotor resistance control. So the word static comes into it because we are going to vary the rotor resistance by using a power electronic circuit. We will use a typical power electronic circuit in order to vary the rotor resistance of the induction motor so that we can have control over it. We will start with the lecture with the brief introduction. So in the conventional method, it is quite difficult to vary the resistance and it's not going to be very precise. So the main advantage of going for static rotor resistance control is that you can vary it steplessly. You can see the first point, because we are going to use a chopper circuit at the rotor side, and the resistance will be connected to the rotor through this chopper circuit. So you all already know the operation of the chopper circuit. The output of the chopper circuit can be varied by varying the duty cycle of the chopper circuit irrespective of its time. So if you are varying the duty cycle, output will be varied. In the same way, we are going to vary the external resistance which we are adding to the rotor side of the induction motor. It has advantages and the disadvantage remains same. We have discussed already in the conventional rotor resistance control of induction motor that the energy at the rotor side will be, the power will be simply dissipated and get wasted. That is the same point which is given here. You can read the last point. The method of speed control is very inefficient because the slip energy is wasted in rotor circuit resistance, right? That is the disadvantage of this method. I will go quite faster with the operation of the circuit and the derivations in order to limit the time, otherwise this video size will become bigger. This is a circuit diagram of the static rotor resistance control of induction motor drive. The stator is connected to the three-phase power supply and the rotor side is taken out and it is connected to the resistor through two different power electronic circuits. So the rotor side is directly connected to the uncontrolled rectifier or diode rectifier, three-phase diode rectifier, that will convert the AC output into DC. There is a DC link inductor link, DC link inductor is also there, and we have a chopper circuit, a typical chopper circuit which is connecting the resistor. External resistor is connected across the switch. It is supposed to be connected across the rotor of the induction motor, right? We'll see the operation. Whatever I just explained to you in the with the help of that circuit diagram is what is being written here. The DC voltage is converted into source current by connecting large series inductor. So that is the purpose of this inductor, which is connected in series to that circuit. And the chopper circuit, there are different types of power electronic switches are used in chopper circuit, IGBT, CGTO and thyristor. In addition to that, there is a spelling mistake in thyristor. In addition to that, BJT and MOSFET also can be used for the circuit, okay. This figure is showing what happens when the chopper switch is on. When the chopper switch is on, the circuit will become short circuited and the current will flow through the switch. Therefore, the net resistance will be zero because there will be no voltage appeared across the resistor. That is VDC is equal to VD equal to zero. VDC is the voltage appear across the resistor, we can say. Sorry, VDC is the output voltage across the bridge rectifier and VDC output voltage across the resistor. Since the resistor is zero, voltage also is zero here at this point when the switch is on. This is the circuit diagram which represents what happens when the IGBT switch is off. So when the switch is off, the current will flow through the resistor and the voltage will appear, whatever is the output voltage across the diode rectifier will appear across the resistor. Here the circuit rotor resistance is now equal to the resistor which we are connecting across the circuit, that means the total resistance is R. So the amount of resistance which is appearing across the rotor is equal to R, and the voltage across the resistor is VDC is equal to now VDC. These two waveforms, three different waveforms are there. One is for resistance during the on and off, what happens to the resistance during the on and off period, and the other one is the voltage during the on and off period, and the third one is the current. So that one shows the rotor current of the circuit. You might have already studied about voltage source inverter and the current source inverter. You have already studied them in power electronics, and in A section we have already discussed about the operation of voltage source inverter fed induction motor. So let me come to the point. So during the on period of the switch there will be no resistance, and R is equal to zero, and during the period of when the switch is off, the net resistance will be equal to R. Similarly, VDC will be equal to, so VD will be equal to VDC during the period of off time of the switch, and VD will be equal to zero during the off period of switch. This is the output waveform of the conventional inverter circuit. You know that already. This slide shows the derivations which is providing the effective resistance value with the help of the chopper circuit. When we are adding a chopper circuit, in order to add external resistance to the induction motor rotor side, this is a derivation which will provide you the effective resistance up there across the rotor side. So we can calculate the effective resistance by means of the total period is 1 over the integral of 0 to t, and the resistance values are with respect to dt. That is divided into two portions, 0 to t and t and to t. These are the fundamental things which you already know very well. By deriving the equation, finally we will get R is equal to R into 1 minus alpha. Alpha is something with the duty cycle, that you can see from this part. Because when during the off period 0 to t on, during the off period the resistance value will be equal to 0, and the resistor appear only during the period of t on to t. So when we are taking it into account, it is 1 over t R by t into t minus t on. T by t is 1 minus t on by t. T on by t is nothing but the duty cycle of the chopper, and we are getting the effective resistance value here, that is R is equal to R into 1 minus alpha. The power consumed by the effective resistance is given with the help of this equation, that is the power appear across the terminal AB. So the power dissipated by the resistor can be calculated with the help of the current ID square into effective resistance. Effective resistance is now the equation of effective resistance is substituted here. This is the derivation for the RMS current of the rotor, 1 by pi 0 to 2 pi by 3 id square into d omega t the whole power 1 by 2. When you integrate this equation, finally you will get I2 is equal to id into square root of 2 by 3. When you rewrite the equation for the current, output current id, you will get an equation of square root of, root of 3 by 2 into I2. We are substituting that value, we will substitute that value here in order to find the effective resistance per phase. So the power consumed per phase can be calculated with the help of, can be obtained with the help of this equation, that is 1 by D ID square into RDEC resistance, internal resistance at the rotor side, and it is 1 minus alpha into R. This is not the what we are going to do is, we are going to substitute ID here. ID is what we have obtained from this equation. ID is the current, that is square root of 3 by 2 into I2, rotor side current. From the rotor side current, we are calculating the DC current, that current, rotor current, right? From the rotor current only, we are calculating this current. That current is being substituted, the current value is being substituted here. Finally, you will get the equation. The final equation for the effective resistance per phase is this value. Effective resistance is 0.5 into Rd plus 1 minus alpha into R. R is the Rd is the resistance at this side. And these are the common notations which we have used during the, used to derive this equation. All these things we have already, I have already explained to you, right? Go back. So the effective rotor resistance Re can be varied by varying the duty cycle of the converter. Now you imagine what will happen to the duty cycle. Let me, in order to have a simple idea about the effective resistance, I will use this equation. See, this is the duty cycle. By varying the duty cycle from 0 to 1, you can effectively vary the resistor value from R to 0. Right? When the duty cycle value is 0, this is going to be R, that is the maximum resistance. When the duty cycle is 1, this is going to be 0. So, by varying alpha from 0 to 1, you can effectively vary the resistor value from 1 to 0. Sorry, R to 0. Okay? And this figure is showing the closed loop control of static rotor resistance control. You have already studied about the closed loop speed control of the motor drive, the two loop control. I discussed in my class during several occasions for different purposes throughout the program during this semester. If you can recall that two loop diagram, it has final, we start always with the motor, right? We have a motor, then motor is connected to a power converter, for example. It can be any motor and any power converter. The motor speed is initially measured with the help of tachometer, that is taken and compared with the speed reference. I hope you remember that. Then the comparator output is given to the speed controller, that will give you the reference current. That reference current is compared with the motor current, then that will provide you the control signal that we are usually giving to the current controller and also to the current limiter to produce the control signal. That control signal is further taken in order to provide the duty cycle or firing pulses to the converter circuit which is connected to the motor. If you have a look at this diagram, it's the same thing. This is your static rotor resistance control part. Speed is measured, the measured speed is compared to the reference speed in the comparator, that is given to the speed amplifier. Here it is given a speed amplifier. Usually you can also write the speed controller here. Then that will provide you the reference current. That reference current is compared with the motor current, then it is producing an error signal. Current error produced by this comparator is given to the current amplifier. That current amplifier providing signal to the firing circuit, and this will provide firing pulse trained to the IGBT switch in order to control the effective resistance. So effective resistance of rotor is controlled by this way, by implementing a closed loop control also. This is achieved. So this is all about the static rotor resistance control. I will just go through a quick review for whatever we have discussed. So this is a circuit diagram of the static rotor resistance control. During the period when the switch is off, effective resistance will be equal to R, and during the period when the switch is on, it will be 0. So that we have seen with the help of this diagram, where the waveforms are presenting the voltage, current and the resistance. Then we derive the effective resistance between the terminals A and B, and also we have calculated the effective resistance per phase with the help of the power equation and the current equation which we have already derived. This is the effective resistance equation which we derived with the help of the operation of the circuit, and also we have seen about the closed loop control or static rotor resistance control. In between, I would have missed something or I would have misinterpreted something because I was in hurry to explain these things. Please bear with me. Thank you.